Hi
children, next topic is method of mixture. Method of mixture. What is the principle of method of mixture? Heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by cold body. So what is the principle of method of mixture? Heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by cold body. But how to derive the formula for method of mixture? So next heading, derivation for formula for method of mixture. Method of mixture. For example, I can take two types of water. One is hot water, another is cold water. First one, what water? Nana? Hot water. Second one is cold water. So mass of hot water is equal to m1, mass of cold water is equal to m2, temperature of hot water is equal to T1. Temperature of cold water is equal to T2. So temperature of hot water is equal to T1. Temperature of cold water is equal to T2. Now hot water is mixed with cold water. Here hot water loss of heat, but cold water gain of heat. That hot water continues to loss of heat? No. After some time, both are attain same temperature. That is thermal equilibrium. So temperature of mixture of water. Mixture of water is equal to T. So this is the thermal equilibrium temperature. So change in temperature of hot water is equal to, here T1 is the highest temperature than T1. So we are comparing T1 and T T1 means hot water temperature. T means mixture of temperature of water. Here T1 is higher, T is lower. So the change in temperature of hot water is T1 minus T. Similarly, change in temperature of cold water. Change in temperature of cold water. Here T2 is compared with T. So here T2 is lower temperature than T. That's why T minus T2. Again, here T is higher, T2 is lower. That's why change in temperature of cold water T minus T2. But here T1 is higher, T is lower. So change in temperature of hot water T1 minus T. Okay, Nana? So mass of hot water M1, cold water M2. Temperature of hot water T1, temperature of cold water T2. So temperature of mixture of water, that means hot water is mixed with cold water, so its temperature is T. Change in temperature of hot water, so T1 is higher, T is lower, so T1 minus T. Change in temperature of cold water T minus T2. You understood? According to principle of method of mixture, heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by cold body. Okay, what is the principle of method of mixture? Heat lost by hot body is equal to heat gained by cold body. What is the formula for heat? Q is equal to MS delta T. What is the mass of hot water? M1. Yes, delta T means change in temperature. So T1 minus T. Similarly, heat gained by cold water. What is the mass of cold water? M2. Specific heat? Yes. Change in temperature? T minus T2. So here, S will be same. That's why we cancel. So M1 into T1 minus T is equal to M2 T minus T2. We are multiplying M1 T1 M1 T. So M1 T1 minus M1 T is equal to M2 T minus M2 T2. Now this minus value move at right side, this minus value moves left side. So M1 T1, this minus M2 T2 come this side, plus M2 T2 is equal to this minus value moves at right side, M1 T plus
m to t.
So now m1 t1 plus m2 t2, here which will be same, t is the same, that's why a common t is equal to m1 plus m2. So t is multiplied with m1 and m2, moves this side. So t is equal to m1 t1 plus m2 t2by m1 plus m2. This is the formula for method of mixture. Again, what is the formula for method of mixture? T is equal to m1 t1 plus m2 t2 by m1 plus m2. Okay, understood? Next topic is evaporation. Now take two petri dishes. How many petri dishes I can take? Two petri dishes. These are the petri dishes. Now take equal amount of spirit is taken in petri dishes. Now close one petri dishes with lid. Now close one petri dishes with lid. Both petri dishes kept in open place for some time. We observe where the spirit will be disappear. With lid, without lid, without lid. Why? Here the spirit molecules moves randomly. Randomly means they are moving irregular. That's why the molecules are collide with each other. If the molecules collide with each other, then energy transfer from one molecule to another molecule. This molecule gain of energy and moves to the surface of the petri dish. Some molecules gain energy and escape into gases. Again, some molecules return back and again collide with each other, then gain of energy. Again, some molecules are escaping from the surface into the air. This process continuously, then spirit molecules will be disappear from the petri dishes. So these spirit molecules escaping from the surface, that's why evaporation is a surface phenomena. So evaporation is a dash phenomena, surface phenomena. But we observe some spirit falls on your palm. We feel coolness. Why? The spirit will be observed some heat from your body and enter into the air. That's why we feel coolness. So evaporation is a gas process, cooling process. So evaporation is a gas process, cooling process. Gas phenomena, surface phenomena. What is called evaporation? The process of escaping of molecules. Here molecules are escaping. Yes or no? Yes. The process of escaping of molecules from the surface of a liquid at any temperature is called evaporation. Again, the process of escaping of molecules from the surface of a liquid at any temperature is called evaporation. Another definition for evaporation: the process of changing from liquid to gas at any temperature. Again, the process of changing from liquid to gas at any temperature is called evaporation. Evaporation is a surface phenomena, cooling process. Next, on what factors evaporation depend? The first one is surface area. Second one, wind speed. Third one, humidity. Okay, Nana. On what factors evaporation depend? Surface area, wind speed, humidity. First one. Now take equal amount of tea, cup and saucer. Again, here I will take saucer and cup and pour equal amount of hot tea in saucer and cup. After some minutes, where the tea will be cool first, saucer or cup? Saucer. Why? Here surface area is more than the cup. So where the surface area more? Cup or saucer? Saucer. Why? Here we observe surface area more in saucer than cup. So surface area increases, then evaporation is also increases. Evaporation nothing but gas process, cooling process. So here more evaporation means more cooling. So tea will be cool first in saucer. We are given conclusion: surface area increases, evaporation is also increases. Understood? Again, equal amount of hot tea in saucer and cup. After few minutes, where the tea will be cool first, saucer. Why? Here surface area increases, then evaporation is also increases. Evaporation, nothing but cooling process. Okay. Next one, wind speed. What is the meaning of wind? Wind means moving air. What is the meaning of wind? Moving air. Now, I can take a wet cloth. Now I can take the wet cloth. Now keep some wet cloth under the fan. So some cloth without under the fan. Where the cloth will be dry faster? Under the fan, without fan. Under the fan. Why? Wind means moving air. This moving air carries the water molecules from the cloth. That's why the cloth will be dry faster under the fan. So we give conclusion. Wind speed increases, then evaporation is also increases. Understood? So where the cloth will be dry faster, under the fan, without fan, under the fan. Why? Wind speed increases, then evaporation is also increases. Next one, humidity. What is the meaning of humidity? Water vapor present in the air. Again, water vapor present in the air is called humidity. So we can keep the wet cloth under the sunlight in the rainy season. That means more humid day, less humid day. More humid day in rainy times, less humid day in summer. So cloths will be dry faster in less humid day. That means less water vapor present in the air. So humidity will be increases, then evaporation decreases. Humidity increases, then evaporation decreases. So these three factors affecting for evaporation. So surface area increases, then evaporation is also increases. Wind speed increases, then evaporation also increases. But humidity increases, then evaporation decreases. Okay, next. So next topic, condensation.